Good morning, good evening, and good waking up. C'est moi, Mai Tai. So like I said earlier, we're just sort of gonna analyze a show's general style together and create characters for the show as if it were ours, and then we'll let you guys loose to do the same thing for yourselves for whatever franchise that you feel like doing. I'm gonna do SpongeBob. I've posted up a bunch of pictures that I looked up for my references for SpongeBob. If you want to do something else, fantastic. I just want you to be thinking analytically in a similar way that I will be talking, because I will be talking. I picked SpongeBob just because it's sort of universal and is also pretty loose with its style. Like, as long as the character... Tongue twisted myself. As long as the characters are, simple and a little loose, and maybe sometimes have a slight emphasis on anatomy in one area or another, but even then, it's really, really, really loose. Going back up to my images. And I also kind of want to use this as a opportunity to explore thumbnailing and gesture for character design, because I think a lot of times in schools and in learning environments, or even when you're on your own, it's pretty easy to just want to jump right in and just do the character. But we take a look at some of the pictures that I posted. Like, these are gestures. Let me bring one over to the screen so it's on camera. Like, these are sketches. These are doodly and rough. They're basically on model, aside from, SpongeBob doesn't have all of his spots or wiggles. Patrick doesn't have all his freckles. But that's not important, right? You can clearly tell who is who. Also, this image, great advice. Fantastic. Good, loose folding and bending and cool shapes. Let me bring my chat back up. I can't see y'all. So, what I want to do first with this is come up with a goal for said character. Like, you're sitting at your desk, and your director busts the door in and points down at the desk and says, We need pictures! We need pictures of elderly women for our show today. You are only drawing grandmas. So, we can look up SpongeBob stuff and start drawing grandmas or whatever, right? So, I'm going to find... Oh, bye, Tofu. Well, I'm glad you came to say hello. Come by next time. Everybody F's in chats for Tofu. We're sad that Tofu's gotta leave. And I didn't actually look up SpongeBob grandmas, did I? I did not. Sponge. I want to look up if hang on, elderly. I can't type and talk at the same time. Elderly fish. Here we go. I want to look up any elderly characters that SpongeBob has already had, just as a jumping off point. This is, I don't necessarily want to draw these guys specifically. Me. Obviously, there's this dude. This dude. Come on. Oh, stop it. What is happening? Technology's failing me. There we go. This dude. Okay. Ah. Sheepy, you are already, like, driving in my lane. Obviously, there's also this lady. Oop, cancel, stop it. And the idea is I just want to see how other episodes have approached elderly characters so that I could just have an idea of what would be appropriate or inappropriate for what this is. And we also want to define what kind of elderly character this is going to be. And I just chose this topic totally randomly. If you want to pick a different one, like maybe you want to do SpongeBob bikers or get more specific. This is the cashier at the 7-Eleven knockoff underwater. I don't know anything ocean related that rhymes with 11. I was gonna do like a, I don't know. Anyway, I'm fried. I'm gonna copy this guy over. I think I like this dude's design. I don't recognize him. There's a lot of SpongeBob episodes I'm missing out on. And then there's also this lady. So, I mean, we could go on. We don't need a ton. And what I want to do is, with my mood board of references that I can regularly come back to, turn it off and stuff, I just want to doodle. Let's doodle. You guys feel like doodling? So, let's do... I'm just gonna do any elderly character. I think just to get started, keep it loose. They can be specific, they don't have to be. Let's just pretend like this is gonna be a background character for some episode. So looking at these guys, with the exception of Chocolate, I think for the most part, it's like a head, a torso, and legs. And the torso may or may not be doubled up, like this guy over here. And then the face holds all the elderly vibes. Except for this. Somebody really pushed this dude to look like pants up to the tits here. It's fantastic. I also like the little like stop part on the shell, but that's not part of his slippers. But he's wearing slippers. But like his arms look like they could belong to any other fish on the show. His legs, aside from the slippers, look like they could be any other fish on the show. Same with these two here. So I'm gonna roll with it. I'm just gonna doodle old. How about you guys? But I really want to emphasize the doodle. Don't sit here and try to create masterpieces. I want to get the idea of like, kind of already think this should be like an eel. Like, there's a stereotype for what elderly people wear from when I'm growing up, and is it the same? Is it different now? Am I old enough for it to be different now? Oh, that's disturbing. Off topic for a second, I just came across this picture, like, of Patrick. I don't see a link on who did it, but like, ooh. That woke me up. I don't like that. Anyway, back to topic. Anyway, I think I'm kind of going for an eel for this one, because eels are cool. That little S curve there. And I remember there being a character who was an eel that looked pretty silly. Yeah. But the legs are all the way down at the bottom. The guy with like with the ice cream cone from that one episode at the beach. Wait, hang on. I love this guy. He just looks so delightful. Look at him. But I like him. So I'm gonna roll with that. I'm gonna steal the leg design here. And the great thing about working on a show like this is that you could totally... Yeah, they all got glasses. I don't know. Chocolate doesn't have glasses. Chocolate doesn't have eyes, though, either. If I remember correctly, her daughter didn't have glasses. She was a good design, too. She looked actually like one of my friend's grandmas. Let's see. Wrong layer. Where's my right layer? Oh gosh, I'm already getting lost. This is bad. Oh gosh, if we're doing like really old style like clothing, I'm gonna steal the high pants. I think on this eel would be pretty funny. And that's one of the great things about designing characters for a show as funky looking as SpongeBob, is that visually you want everything to be entertaining just to look at too. Whether it's just because they're just ever so silly, like look at this, I love him, he's so happy. You can't see my hands, but I'm gesturing towards the beheaded eel guy with his little thing of juice. Oh, damn, I could go for some juice. Even like these other old people caricatures, like Chocolate's just a spine. This little old lady here with her, like, just everything about her is kind of wonderful. And I think the elderly dude next to her, I know, like, it's not, like, a thing that they're related, but I'm just gonna go ahead and make it the canon that they're twins. Like, look at them. They're definitely from the same family. I guess he might be older than her. I don't know. But, anyway, don't spend, like, a whole lot of time on these. You just want to throw the idea in there. Even if it's super, super riff. Wait, do walkers have like tennis balls in all of them? Hang on. Walker. Tennis balls. Ah, okay, just the back ones. And then it's wheels. Okay. Wow, this is terrible. At least get your lines straight, Mai Tai. Goodness and gracious. There we go. this doesn't look anything like a walker. I even have a reference up. What am I doing? Okay. I know I just said that it doesn't have to be perfect or anything, but it does have to read. So let's see. Here's my box. Oh, I'm putting it far too much in front of him. And then there's the... Okay, alright. This makes a little more sense. I get it now. Nope, too close. Line and line. Okay, that looks more like a walker. We did it! As a family! trying to give this. Okay. Does he need suspenders? Or just a nice button down. We'll just give him a button down. This guy's so tall, I'm not even sure suspenders would be necessary. The belt will do. And give him long pants. Okay. Elderly fish number one, ready for his first meeting with the big boss. Oh, hello, big boss. I designed one dude. Okay, but we need a lot to pick from, so let's do another one. I'm gonna go ahead and turn these off so I can make room, but we're gonna pretend like as I'm drawing, you guys can still see them. A different kind of fish. Let's just do generic fish-like creature. Like, I'm not even gonna reference a fish for this. Wait, does he need teeth? Okay, he doesn't need them, but I like them, so I'm gonna keep them. Okay. Oh, I forgot to finish his tennis balls. Okay, one. And the other one would be, like, back here. Okay, cool. Good enough. Alright. So... Wait, you know what? I know I just said I didn't want to, like, reference a specific fish, but I just had a great idea, and I now have to remember, is it the parrotfish that has that weird bulbous thing on their head? What am I thinking? No, they have crazy teeth, though. Yikes. Okay. Okay, so some of them do have that, but what's the one I'm thinking of? Flowhorn? Is that a flower horn? Is that it? Yeah, okay. Are these ocean fish? I think they're ocean fish. These guys are funky. Like, look at this. Hang on. I'm gonna post it. Whoa, that looks kind of fun to do, so let's do it. Okay, alright. Elderly character, definitely from SpongeBob, I swear I'm hired, definitely for sure, I work there, ha ha ha, hire me now. Big thing. Yeah, okay, so, XD Melody says it has a big brain, so I guess the question is... Do I want to go with that? Is this elderly fish really big brained? Or does he just have a massive forehead, like, folding over his eyes like a Invader Zim character? Because I guess he could be both, huh?
I think I want to give this guy glasses too. Listen, with all the screen time we all get, by the time we're this fish's age, we're all gonna need glasses too. It's too late. It's happening. It looks like an afro now. Yeah, I guess it does. Actually, this guy looks a little bit like... not quite. He almost looks like... trying to think of her name. Just somebody I know. My brain hurty. I need more coffee. Come here, coffee. Oh god, do any of you guys draw with the blue light stuff on? I can't do it. My friend got those glasses because he does a lot of programming. That like filter things and they kind of look like Clark Kent glasses. And I can't. I probably could if I'm just working in black and white for the most part. I guess that wouldn't be a bad idea to think about. What does this guy look like? Where? It's bothering me. I'm giving little legs though. One of my favorite elderly person, I guess, shapes is really big, but like the smallest, spindliest legs. My grandpa's like that. He's like 6 foot something and he's really big, but he's like all leg. It's amazing. If he had a longer face, he'd look like that acrobat in Coraline, but he's got a round face. He'd kind of look like this. Well, he still has his hair. He's an angry man. I love him. Anyway. Ghostfish says, fun fact, drawing for long periods of time with no breaks can blur your vision. Fun fact, that is not only super true, but if it's the first thing you do in the morning, that's all day. Good luck. Take those breaks. Supposedly, if you do like 20 minutes of work on something where you're close up, then you need like 20 seconds of just uninterrupted visual stimulus elsewhere far away. Maybe we should have a class where all we do is, like, stuff to help with, like, physical health as an artist. Because, like, you gotta take care of your hands and your back and your legs and your hips and, like, everything is all connected to and whatever. Look at the wall on the other side of the room, yeah. I'm gonna give this guy weird kneecaps and long socks. Why does SpongeBob get all the fun long socks? Everybody else, just get some loafers, man. Long socks and loafers. Okay. Old man fish number two. And it's shortened. Let's at least make these guys look like they're just scale to each other. Yeah, it looks okay. No!
happens to select. That's good. Okay. Oh, socks with sandals! Damn it! I should do that! You're right! Thanks, Mori Isadana. You're right. Just thinking about, like, I was just referencing my grandfather, too, and he does that! And I don't know why. The dude works in construction. I don't even know if he owns... he probably owns boots. Did I erase the whole foot? I just got excited for socks and sandals. Oh god, I am getting old. Okay. Oh yeah. That's the good stuff. That's terrible. I hate it. Kneecaps be shaking. Yeah, they do. Should I give him a cane? Nah, I just want him to look like he waddles when he walks. Alright, let's get some ladies in here. Oh, I'm gonna do a Betty White. Let's do a Betty White fish. By the way, guys, as you guys are drawing along with me, you should totally post up, like, any of you, the people you're coming up with. Oh, what the hell? Dude, young Betty White was gorgeous. Completely off topic, like, just... Wow! Okay, anybody else, like, seeing the end of her bracelet here, but the rest of it's blending in, so when you're not looking at her hand, you're like, where's her hand? Did it get cut off? I should design a Betty White pirate sometime. Anyway, back to topic. Let's get... Cuppy. Let's get her lovely face in here. Betty White, patron saint of alcohol and giggles. God's ain't gonna help you, so give the sorrow for what you've done. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Getting some memory flashbacks. I'm trying to bring my mind to, like, every shoulder padded shirt and jacket I've ever come across at like a Goodwill. We've got to get that. Like, I still dress like I come out of the 80s or 70s, whenever shoulder pads were popular. Let's get that guy out of there. Oh, is that Ryan Reynolds? Oh yeah, okay. Da-da-da-da-da. Okay. I know she doesn't have, like, really beady eyes, but I want to make this fish look like she definitely has baked cookies already ready, and she hasn't even met you yet. But I want to do it in a way... Okay, Betty White is, like, one insincere smile away from looking like a real estate agent. And I just, like, it sounds like such an insult, but, like, she's got such a sweet face. And when I think real estate agent, I think a lot of the same outfits, but without the sweet face. don't know if that looks fish enough. Alright, let's bring back the elderly. Where's... Come back. Nope. Wrong layer. Get back over here. Yeah, I'm already getting off there. It doesn't really look... What layer did I draw her on? No! Let's get back to my fish layer. Not that one. This one. Okay, let's label that. Oh, yeah, SpongeBob's grandma. Okay. You know what? Yeah, let's look at SpongeBob's grandma and let's see what we can do about making her into a fish. I think that would be a pretty close way to get Betty White. I had a woman in my neighborhood who was everybody's grandma, who just gave similar vibes to SpongeBob's grandma. There's an N in grandma. Learn to type, Maya. Okay. But we all called her Mama. She'd like babysit every kid on the block and she was like lived right across the street from me, so some days I would just like waltz over to her house and like hang out with her grandkids. She and her husband were really sweet. Anyway. Well, I don't want to do the nose. But that does give me a better idea on face stuff. When I think Betty White, I definitely think of her hair. And her big pearl earrings. Yeah, okay. Way better. Oh, look at her. I'm so happy with this. I'm gonna keep these really small. There we go. To put chat back up. Hi guys, I'm back. Okay, I was too busy looking at Google, but I'm not too busy for you guys. Let's see. I love the red with the flared collar, so I'm gonna keep that. I don't understand brooches, but I suppose I should probably do something. I'm thinking way too much about this hair. There. How are you guys doing? What are y'all working on?
Don't be shy. There we go. Is there anything you guys wanted to go over specifically today? Like, or if there's any, like, questions? Like I said, like, it's definitely a really loose thing, as far as, you know, our topic is concerned. So, if there's anything that you guys want to ask or get some feedback on, I don't even care if it's related to the topic today, to be honest. I think I just want to loosen up a little. Keep it cash. All right. Grandma number one, elderly number three. Let's turn these guys off so I can move her over. Yeah, it worked out. She looks pretty okay. Too large, though. And a lot of cars driving by with those weird popping engines. My inner elderly person wants to walk out there with a baseball bat and say, "Get off my street!" Okay, so boss man director comes in, sees I've got three people, and is like, okay. So, where's the rest of them? Well, darn. Let's do more. Let's do, like, I don't know, five? I don't know what would be an appropriate number for, like, a Nickelodeon environment for how many elderly background characters to choose from. Let's do something a little triangular. Let's do... Let's look up ocean fish. That's generic, right? Ooh. I think I already did an eel one, so why should I do another? But I am tempted. Oh, I know. Okay. Just a grumpy guy. Any of you guys got some cool weekend plans? I'm looking forward to just sort of vegging out a lot of tomorrow, at least. Those sad cheeks. He misses his hair. Sleeping and drawing. Haha, mood. Yeah. Oh, school quarter. How long do you have until it is over?
like 4 weeks. Oh, Melody, I'm sorry. Testing in about a week too. Wow. I know some of my students who are in elementary school and middle school still, not elementary, just middle school, I think. They're going through their like SATs and stuff now, and not SAT. What's it called? It was STAR testing when I was their age, but it's different now. Just state testing. Ugh.
This guy really doesn't need a lot. He already looks pretty good. I'm gonna make his head shiny. There we go. How do those little petal things connect to the... I'm doing my STAR testing. Oh, gosh. Gosh. I don't remember. Did STAR testing go through high school? I think it did. I remember the year that I stopped doing testing was, like, freeing, but it wasn't... I don't remember when it was. Because it wasn't, like, the year I graduated. I mean, Lee, it could have... I know senior year we had the SATs and stuff, but I don't know. It was so traumatic. All my thoughts and emotions and memories of high school are just a blur, darling. I'm sorry. Math and history next week. Ugh. Where's that picture with the wheelchairs? Well, yeah, I can just steal the one from Chocolate. I don't know how wheelchairs work. Do they still have, like half days for testing, though? Or, like, more breaks? I remember some of my teachers having, like, pizza and stuff, but I think that was when I was, like, middle school, but... Oh, wow, okay, I'm actually not that far off. Okay, so... We got the chair... I'm just saying, silver lining could include pizza. Ugh. XD Melody says, there's hardly any breaks where I go to school. Melody, I am so sorry. You know, in my high school, it was, you got a half an hour for lunch, and then there was, like, a 15-minute break an hour or two before that. But that was it. Which, I guess, isn't really that bad. It just never felt like enough. Especially since I'd be there from, like, 7 in the morning some days. Like, school started at 8, but I used to go there early because my sister had to... an extra morning class, and I didn't feel like finding my own way there. The last break I got was spring break, but even that was only 1 week. Yeah, Have those gotten shorter? Like, my memory is that spring break was, like, 2 weeks long, or a week and a half, or something. Maybe I'm just insane. Like, my sense for time is just terrible, so I could just be wrong. That's a bummer, though. I think that looks close enough. He's so shiny. Okay, let's do one more elderly fish, and then I will move on to a new SpongeBob-related topic to doodle. So I actually have a question for you guys, and this might be a question I open up in the full chat at some point. But would you want a quote-unquote sort of kind of a class where it's just critique, like just like redlining and stuff? It would be streams like this, and I don't know, I guess that would mean potentially streamed elsewhere too. But it's something I've done before, and I thought it was a lot of fun, and it was interesting, but... That's three big yeses. Okay, all right. Oh, that little cat's cute. What a chill dude. Though critiquing what? I don't know. I mean, artwork, for sure. Like, I'm definitely not gonna, like, critique your sculpting abilities. I'm not a good sculptor, myself. Or a singer. I'm a terrible critique of singing. I just know what I don't like. So I can't help you there. I tried putting my cat in one of those harness leashes for the first time recently, and the poor dude just sort of shut down. Oh, great question. So the question is, would it be like 1 week we do a class and then following the week is critique or just overall class-related things? My initial thought was just like, bring in some stuff. It would be like the art review, but live. So like whatever you're working on, but you know what, that's not a bad idea to have one relating to a previous class and just have it be like feedback from what you guys maybe theoretically drew today. I'm gonna tentatively put a pin in that as both of these things, because that's awesome. I don't even look like a... He looks like a duck. That is... Oh, wait. We don't have any elderly characters. Or actually, do we have any other characters in SpongeBob that are also wearing the suits? Let's bring Sandy's, like, dad or something in here. I was also thinking of doing, like, a distraction day where, and this would probably not be every week, but just a day where, like, people stream and hang out and do something other than the thing they're studying. So, like, if you're studying for illustration, then draw anything else. Something just out of the comfort zone, but still fun. Or, like, because it's, I think, really important to learn how to sort of stave off the art block as it, like, before it comes, or, like, to kind of get accustomed to doing other things, to take breaks and still feel creatively inspired by something else for a little while. And I think that could help. Also, it just sounds like fun to, like, pop on and say, hey, we're painting today, or... hey, it's puzzle day. I got a puzzle, you get a puzzle too. Let's puzzle it out. I don't know. Okay, okay. Because I don't know about you guys. The more breaks that I take, the easier it is to jump back in again. What do Sandy's ears look like? They're just little nubs, right? Yeah, they're just little nubs. The more and more breaks they take, the longer they become. Yeah, I mean that too. Not really elderly, but he is older. Oh, nice. I'm gonna bring these over because these look really good. Open, open. Thank you. Do, 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 do. So these were Mora Zadana, and these are pretty great. These look like, I really love how your like super skinny dude in the middle turned out with the stash and everything. Like he looks like somebody I've seen before for sure. These are great. I love how, like, drippy this woman is, too. Like, she is on her way lower and lower to the ground. This is wonderful. I am spending way too much time sketching this dude out. There we go.
Yeah, honestly, Adana, I think you should, like, finish those. Like, clean them up, ink them, color them. Those are awesome.
You know what? I tell you what, guys. Let's make this the first one that we turn into a critique thing. As you finish up your show-related characters, I want you to either...
Let's see, what are the other things we have in here? One second. I want you to either post them here in the chat, and if it's not SpongeBob, make sure you include which show it's or media, whatever it is from, as part of the post and what your goal was. So if it's like redesigning background characters for Naruto, then cool, just let me know. And you could also just send them straight to me as a DM. And then on Monday, we'll go over some of them for Redline, like just for a critique. If you're not up for that, obviously, then don't send it to me. That's fine. But let's plan a day to get that started, because I feel like this is one of those things. If I just talk about it, it's like, hey, wouldn't that be fun? Then we won't do it. So I think we should do it. And then on Monday, we'll actually still have, like, a separate, like, lesson to go over. So I'm thinking maybe I can start earlier, because I don't have to be anywhere Monday evening, so I could probably start earlier than 5:30. How does one draw circles? Why am I struggling with this? Ugh. Get good sleep where you don't... You lose your skill to draw circles. That's just how life is today. I've slept like a baby, which is like waking up every 2 hours and crying my butt off. I mean, I wasn't crying, but after the fifth time waking up, I definitely wanted to. I didn't actually wake up 5 times, but I just couldn't. I just feel like a zombie today. Yeah, I want to sleep when you go into a coma for a few hours. What is life even? When you're not in a coma for many days at a time. What is love? Baby, don't hurt me no more. There we go. Sandy Dad. Those are lines that work. Oh, uh-oh. No. Are you kidding me? Okay. All right, for a second I thought the battery on my stylus died. Like, I literally just charged it. It's the one thing I don't like about... Actually, there's a couple small things, but this is one of the things I don't like about the XP pens. Is the one that I have, I think some of the newer ones are less of an issue, but I've got the 16 Pro, and I have to charge these styluses. Hello, neighbor. And the older they get, the more often I have to charge them, and that's really irritating. Like, some of these are down to, like, they won't hold a charge for, like, a week. 2 weeks. This one, I think I charged last week, so it should be okay. And this is my newer one, but like, ugh. Okay. So, the main goal of this is just, like, if you were to put one of these characters next to the main cast, would they look completely out of place? Some of the caricatures of SpongeBob... Well, that's not SpongeBob at all. Go away, Betty White. I love you, but get out of here. Stop haunting my halls. Go back where you belong. Get rid of that fish, too. But, how out of place would they look? And there's a bit of a ratio, or a threshold, really, of how far you can take something stylistically within a franchise. And for SpongeBob, it's a pretty large threshold, right? Like, you can look at, like, these guys look like they could be from the same show, but with this little dude here, like, the style is way more simplified, so it's sort of pushing it. And then you get, like, really detailed looking characters like, where is she? That narwhal. I just had her up here. Let me scroll up for a second. It's in the chat. Or, like, this funky horse fish. They don't all read exactly, but they're just similar enough in their simplification that they fit. But something like, sorry, I got distracted by a picture. Something like Looney Tunes might be a little bit tighter with their choices, or Fairly Odd Parents has a very specific set of style rules in terms of, like, how sharp or clean or simplified something ought to be, right? Too many little lines and it won't really fit in. So, that's kind of the main goal, is, like, how can you compare and contrast? And the best way to analyze it is if you're looking at multiple characters from the show, at once, like we did here. Like, I had some pictures of the main cast in the chat, and then also some of the newer things. So, when it's more specific, you want to look at, like, okay, so if these characters here can get away with this shape in this fashion, can I? Obviously, yes. If I tweak it to be a little different, will it still look out of place? And you have to kind of trust your instinct on that. And at the moment, we're strictly looking at shape design. I don't care about the color choices or how it's inked. Those all have their own fundamentals that correlate into the style of your show or media of choice. But for the sake of this project, it's just doodly sketchwork, right? They can be as constructed as you want, as long as when you share them with whoever they're going to be shared with, whether it's on social media or you're sending it to me for the red line day on Monday, or if it's for your director, or if you're like an apprentice for a comic or something, it needs to be clear, right? Like, these are messy, these are rough, but they're clear. Let me get these out of the way so that you can see you can bask in the clarity of my elderly fish. So there's no point where I'm looking at something and questioning what's going on. We get a little bit too rough right down here, but you can still see, like, ah, yeah, it's those thingies that his feet rest on, and there's the wheel and stuff. It's the walker or whatever. So it doesn't have to be the highest quality. They don't have to be inked and pretty. If you want to color them, cool, whatever. It's a pretty short class today. There's not a whole lot that I need to go over specifically. I'd like to make Monday's lesson about inking, because I think that's something that gets a little bit neglected when talking about character design. Most of the character design courses I see online are just about the actual structural design, and by the end of those classes, there's still a finished, polished piece, and they might talk about color and choosing, but it's just like, yeah, and there's lines, and it's just sort of incidental. And there's a bit of a There's a bit of a math to line work. Just a little bit. So with that, I don't know about you guys, but I get the feeling that there's more than one of you who agree with me that it might be nap time. And, so we're gonna cut it short today. I desperately need to curl up on the couch and question my choices, specifically the choices involving what show I'm gonna put on to fall asleep to. And I will see you guys on Monday. So like I said, send me anything you want to send that you're willing to get redlined. However, I'm going to prioritize... I didn't say this part, actually. I am going to prioritize those relating to this concept of creating new characters for an existing franchise. If you have any questions at any point between now and Monday, just send them. Hit me up anytime. I won't be able to get to you right away sometimes, but I will do my best to at least let you know that I saw your message. And with that, I will catch you guys later. Enjoy your various naps as well. Good night, everybody. Oh, what time? Deadline Monday. 5:30 PST in the evening. So about this, anytime before class starts again. Because if you send it to me during class, I might not have time to get to it. I just am going to predict that there's going to be a few. I might open up the floor to it. This is pretty loose, just sort of getting into the idea of what this is going to be like. So, yep, just, you know, before 5:30 PST, PM PST on Monday. Okay, good night, everybody. Enjoy your various naps and dinners and doodle away. Have fun. Did I forget to hit record? Oh, good, I didn't. Okay, good night recording. See you next time.